Folk singing is a lovely art and a universal one. And we're extremely fortunate to have with us this evening two Australian Mexicans from Tokyo who are going to sing us a small song arranged and written by Benjamin Britten in Scottish.
Corby's in the gloaming, Pretty Betty in the glen lifts her skirts, violent men, mickle, tickle, feather, heather, then she puts them nude again. We are half a sparring kettle, mickle, mackle, kilt, a sparring metal, kettle, mickle, pickle, dock and dorings, not forgotten. Corby's in the gloaming, Corby's in the gloaming. Pretty Betty was ensnared by a rich and aged laird, mickle, buckle, ochawa, the dirty little tartan. Wheel, mackle, spar and kettle, mickle, mackle, kilt and spar and myrtle, kettle, mickle, pickle, dock and dorings, not forgotten. Corby's in the gloaming, Corby's in the gloaming. John McDougal wears a kilt and finds it muckle drafty, found a gilly in his kilt, these queers are muckle crafty. Wheel, mackle, spar and kettle, mickle, mackle, kilt and spar and myrtle, kettle, mickle, pickle, dock and dorings, not forgotten. Corby's in the gloaming, Corby's in the gloaming.
I'd like to recite to you now a poem by one of my ancestors, Sir Joshua Hendra, who was a 17th century Cornish poet master. I've learned this poem from the original manuscripts, which are Cotton Nero 279 Heppelthwaite Collection, Brit Mus. Upon his mithraps bubum, by Sir Joshua Hendra, Bart. Softly, softly blows the gale upon my mithraps bosom pale. Yet feel not for me my thirst to flake, and thus I lie despairing, for it's fake. If I that bosom were possessing, it would not to me be distressing. Spice and force I would not use, unlike those lovers who abuse the tasteless nets of common bags. My mithraps bosom never fags. Fee, fee, where she fits upon her feet, her visage hostile and her orbs discreet. Oh, for my misery I find no text, when foe by that bosom I am vexed. Oh, oh,
oh,
oh. I am a sailor on a fee of woe.
We'd like to sing you now, quite seriously, one of the most beautiful lyrics ever written in the English language. What else could I mean but Wordsworth's very famous poem, To the Daffodils.
I wander lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er paving hills, where all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. Beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Where up the bum, my